episode 2037, when a season becomes the standard.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people happy, happy day. How are you doing? I mean, seriously, has anybody asked you that question recently? You know, sometimes we get so disconnected with so many people that we love that we forget that we're human ourselves. Today is Relationship Builders. It's about building a strong foundation with the person you love the most, your spouse, when a season becomes the standard. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, there is a time for everything, but what happens when a season becomes the standard in your marriage? You know, change is a constant. So why is it so challenging in marriage? Why can't we just, you know, click our fingers and all of a sudden everything's better or flip a switch? It's easy to settle into a season even though you hope for change. Why? Well, because the pain of change is not greater than the season you're in. It's easy to stay grounded in what you know. I mean, think about that for a minute. The pain of change, going through that transition to gain the transformation, if it's not greater than the season that you're in, what's happening right now, do you think you're going to do it? No, because you're comfortable with where you are. And that includes the seasons that are tough and uncomfortable. You may not like where you are, but since you know what to expect, there is less hassle and more living, even though the living is not what you hoped it would be. You just stay there. You don't work for anymore. Talk about the circle of life. Who needs change when you can have comfort, even though it brings discomfort? Think about it. Isn't marriage to some degree about comfort? You spending a life together with the one you love, adventure awaits. Comfort is simply that, comfort. You know it, so why not accept it? But as life changes, so does your marriage. Your relationship is stretched in many different directions. Some circumstances you handle like a champ. Yes, rock on. And others, not so much. You also grow personally, which brings its own set of challenges. You probably have experienced knowing that you've gone through a personal growth spurt. I'm not talking about height or weight. No, we're past that. I'm talking about your mindset. I'm talking about your internal being, as in how you see things, your lenses, your perspective, right? There is some wisdom that comes with age. And so when you grow personally, but you don't feel like your spouse is growing, there's some disconnect there. So what happens when a season becomes the standard? Well, the everyday is too monotonous. It's the same old, same old, same old. Whether it's good, bad, or ugly, it's the same thing every day. There's also a lack of intrigue and mystery. Yeah, what do you think it was like when you were dating? Intrigue and mystery. You were in search. You were after chasing one another, trying to figure out the cute quirks, trying to figure out what made your spouse tick. You wanted to know what made them smile and light up a room. That's intrigue. That's mystery. But years after years after years of marriage and being together, you lose that. And if you fall into a season that now is a standard and it's not one that's really a good one for you, yeah, you're losing out on the intrigue and mystery. There's also days that are more about everyone else and not you as a couple. Do you have children? Do you have furry puppy dogs or kitty cats? They sometimes demand more of your time, which takes away from your time as a couple. If you have a newborn, an infant, a toddler, a young elementary child, you've got some incredible focus and demands on what they need from you, right? If you have a newborn, you are feeding that child because that child cannot fend for himself. They can't go and just pop in a bottle and have it all ready and, you know, drink it down. Okay, next, belly up at the bar. No, it doesn't work that way. Wouldn't it be nice? We would have lots of children in the world. But no, we have to care for them and nurture them. And then when you start to get to preteens and teens and tweens and all that jazz, what happens then? Oh, they begin to get into mischief and they begin to go through puberty and they have their life changes and the drama and the girlfriends and the boyfriends. And so sometimes the family actually draws us further apart from our spouse when actually it needs to be drawing us closer together. That's when a season can become a standard. Also, another thing, communication weakens and disagreements or disconnects occur more frequently. When you're not talking, then guess what? You're not on the same page. You don't know what's happening with each other. And so you're going to have these disconnects. You're going to have disagreements because you're not reading each other's mind anymore. Do you remember the days when you could finish each other's sentences? That's pretty cool. Are you doing that now? Also, what happens when a season becomes a standard? This is one that comes up all the time when I talk to both male and females. Dreams and goals don't align. There's something different, Christiane. I don't know what it is, but I'm seeing one thing and man, she was all in support of my dreams. And now it's all about her. I don't know what happened. Oh, and you know, he was all about me going back and getting my PhD, but now he's like, no, can't you just stop with your master's? Dreams and goals don't align. Things have shifted. Ultimately, you get comfortable being uncomfortable. That's when a season becomes the standard. Your comfort is your new comfort, even though you're uncomfortable. So you just stay there. You hang out. That's what it boils down to. It's that discomfort in your everyday. But what if you're done with that season and you're ready for a new standard? You're like, sign me up for something new and fresh. I'm tired of doing the same old thing. I can't stand this any longer. The pain of change, I'm willing to take that risk. Well, you got to alter your outlook. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Alter your outlook. Be honest about what is happening in your marriage. Stop wearing blinders. Stop sugarcoating things. Stop talking to people you shouldn't be talking to about your marriage. Because most of the time, that is not fruitful for your marriage. You're just complaining. And complaining does nothing when it comes to changing to get you in transition to create transformation. You've got to be willing to lead, listen, and love your way through the transition. So how do you alter your outlook? Number one, look for what isn't working. What you see is not what you get always. What you think might be the problem or challenge may not be. So be honest with yourself and your spouse and look for what isn't working. You got to know that in order to move forward, right? You have to understand the quirks, the season that you're in. What is it? Be specific. Number two, know the results you desire. What do you want to see in your marriage? Where do you want to go with it? When you get into a car, you know that you're going from point A to point B. Not very many people just get in a car and start driving. Unless if you're like me and you move every few years and you're getting to know a community, then you do just get into the car. You have a GPS, but you just start driving and you hit main roads and you just see what you can find. That's adventurous, let me tell you. You have no idea where you end up. You just hope that you can find your way back to either the hotel or the house you're renting or the new house you just bought. Either way, it's kind of crazy. But you have to know the results you desire. Where are you headed? So what is it that you want in your marriage? Number one, look for what isn't working. Number two, know the results you desire. And finally, number three, aim for the challenge. Action ignites motivation. If you are not actively pursuing what you want and what you desire in your marriage, do you think you're going to get that change? No, you're not. It's going to stay in the same comfort zone that you're in, and you're going to be uncomfortably comfortable for a long period of time. So aim for the change. Plan what needs to happen in order to begin to see a shift in your season or the rut that you're in. And it's baby steps, not massive marathons. Think about how long it's taken you to get to where you are today. You cannot blink and have it change overnight. It doesn't work that way. Yes, do I believe in miracles? And can things happen in a blink? Yes, they do. But you know what? If you look back, you will see the little breadcrumbs from heaven. And you will understand that, wait a minute, the transition has been happening over a period of time. You just didn't see it in the making. I know, because I've been down that path. And it's amazing to see it all happen. But you've got to aim for the change. Ecclesiastes 3:1, there is a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. Therefore, know that change is a constant, but comfort is not. Seasons will come and go, but through it all, you set the standard. If you don't like where you are in your marriage, then do something about it. Complaining is not going to change your marriage. So stop it already. Yes, you need someone to be able to feel safe with and to discuss what's happening. That's a difference. But just to sit there and complain and just shout out words and badmouth your spouse, no, bury that hatchet. You need to look at where you are. What do you want in the results? Where are you headed as a couple? And get on the same page. You can look at this individually, but then what has to happen? You got to come together with it. And you've got to begin to understand each other. And so that's where you begin to live, love, and impact. You say, look, hon, this is what I see. What do you see? And it's not about right or wrong. Remember, your perspective is going to be different than what your spouse sees. And that's okay. So don't bring expectations to your discussion. Open your heart to hear someone else's heart, your spouse's heart. So you understand that position. So then you can go ahead and begin the process. I promise you it works, but it does take work. And it requires you to get out of your comfort zone and be uncomfortable in a situation where there is no comfort. Change is a constant, but the standard you set. Go out today, live, love, and impact. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.